This is Shuttle Launch Control at T-minus 3 hours and holding, where the astronauts and their crew quarters are just entering the dining room for breakfast. Their activities are right on schedule this morning. And here are all six of our STS-77 crew members ready for breakfast and our traditional cake on the table. At the end, Mission Specialist Dan Bursch, our flight engineer on this mission. Kurt Brown, our pilot on this flight, will be busy with numerous rendezvous activities, along with our commander, John Casper, making his fourth flight into space today. Mission Specialist Mario Runco making his third trip into space. Mission Specialist previously in 1991 and 1993. And Andy Thomas from Australia, our payload commander, during the flight from Australia, and a Canadian mission specialist, Marc Garneau. And all of our payload team, now our commander and pilot, and our flight engineer at the far end. This is Shuttle Launch Control at T-minus 3 hours and holding. The astronauts have just completed their weather briefing and are now moving to the suit-up room. This is Shuttle Launch Control at T-minus 3 hours and holding, where we're in the suit-up room now with the astronauts. We just saw our commander, John Casper, and here is pilot Kurt Brown. And here is Mission Specialist Andy Thomas. He's our payload commander from Southern Australia. He has considerable background in microgravity research, having been at NASA's, at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena before joining the astronaut corps. So with all the microgravity research on this flight, he's the logical one to be taking that responsibility for the oversight of all of this microgravity research on this mission. And here is Dan Bursch making his third flight. He flew previously on STS-51 in 1993 and STS-68 in 1994, so this is his third flight. He'll be our flight engineer on this mission. Here is Canadian mission specialist Marc Garneau. He'll be doing a number of microgravity research position experiments, particularly with the Aquatic Research Facility. This is his second flight into space. He was a payload specialist previously on STS-41G in 1984. And here is Mario Runco making his third trip into space. He was on STS-44 in 1991 and STS-54 in 1993. He was an environmental services officer in the Navy. We have about a minute left in this built-in hold. Crew should be preparing to leave the astronaut quarters here in just another couple of minutes. Again, and here are our astronauts now, just leaving the suit-up room, headed for the elevator on third floor of the operations and checkout building located in the KSC industrial area. And Director of Flight Crew Operations Dave Leesma is with them. Bob Cabana will be flying the weather reconnaissance this morning. they'll be entering the Astrovan here momentarily, where we see members of the media and KSC employees. And here they come. John Casper now. So we have a good deal of flexibility to launch based on any number of wind patterns that we see. And right now it doesn't look like upper level winds are any issue for us at all today. Mario Runco will be sitting in the seat next to the crew orbiter access hatch in the mid-deck. And next to them is Dr. Marc Garneau, who has already boarded. Up on the flight deck, Dan Bursch, as the flight engineer, will sit in the aft center seat. And payload commander Andy Thomas will sit in the aft right seat behind pilot Kurt Brown. Kurt Brown and Marc Garneau will switch on landing. Kurt Brown will sit on the mid-deck next to Mario Runco. And Andy Thomas will move up.
OTC, OBCC. Go ahead. MS3 in now at 53 after.
OTC, CDR.
Go ahead, CDR.
Yes, we're ready for the Astrocom check.
Okay, copy that. And it's OTC on 212. Any conversation on OIS channel 212 during Astrocom check will be heard by the crew. Channel should remain silent except for emergency calls. And for the flight crew, OTC during Astrocom check, adjust your appropriate volume control on Airground 1, 2, ICOM A, B, or Air to Air for comfort. Do not change audio panel switch configuration. Now let's go ahead and do a two-way comm check here on Air to Ground 1. Endeavor, OTC, Air to Ground 1, how do you read?
CDR, loud and clear. PLT, loud and clear. MS-1, loud and clear. MS-2, loud and clear. MS-3, loud and clear. MS-4, loud and clear.
Verifying all of our TDRS launch commit criteria are verified. Standing by to retract the orbiter access arm.
Yeah, let's just go for orbiter access arm retract.
down to internal reactants. Pop
ATC,
off.
ATC, warning, memory clear, complete, no unexpected notes.
Copy that. Endeavor OTC, close and lock your visors, initiate O2 flow, and we all give you our best wishes for a smooth ride up the hill.
Roger and work, and we'll see you in 10 days.
T-minus 2 minutes. Top off of fuel cells terminated. Liquid hydrogen tank now on the bottom two-thirds of the external tank being pressurized. SRB nozzles gimbal to flight position. Firing chain is armed. Sound suppression water system is activated. Range safety command systems are armed. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7. Ignition sequence start. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. And liftoff of the Space Shuttle Endeavour to develop the practical and the beneficial aspects of space.
Roll program, Houston.
Roger, roll, Endeavour.
Houston now controlling. Endeavour's underway on its 11th trip to space. Currently rolling on course for an east-northeast trajectory away from the Kennedy Space Center toward a 39-degree inclination, 153 nautical mile altitude orbit. Three engines on board Endeavour have now throttled back to two-thirds throttle to prepare the spacecraft to pass through the area of maximum air pressure and go supersonic. Endeavour speed now 700 miles per hour, altitude 4.5 miles.
Endeavour, go at throttle up.
Go at throttle up.
Three engines on Endeavour now back at full throttle. Altitude 10 miles. Endeavour traveling 1,400 miles per hour, 8 miles east-northeast of the Kennedy Space Center. 1.5 minutes since launch, Endeavour's already used more than 2.25 million pounds of propellant. The spacecraft weighs less than half of what it did at liftoff. One minute, 50 seconds since liftoff. Endeavour now traveling 2,700 miles per hour. Altitude 24 miles. 24 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center. Flight controller standing by for burnout and jettison of the twin solid rockets. Booster officer confirms a good jettison of the twin solid rockets. Endeavour now in second stage main engines.
Endeavour, performance nominal.
Copy, nominal.
PLT, OTC, clear caution, warning memory, verify no unexpected errors.
PLT and what?
Endeavour OTC, close and lock your visors, initiate O2 flow, and we all give you our best wishes for a smooth ride up the hill.
Flight booster locks.
Roger and work, and we'll see you in 10 days.
Let's just go from main engine.
All vents open.
Copy.
T0, FRB ignition.
Liftoff confirmed.
Copy.
Roll program, Houston.
Roger, roll, Endeavour.
In flight, we see the roll.
Copy. Press to ATO.
Endeavour, press to ATO.
Press to ATO.
Morning, Andy.
Good morning, Bill.
Endeavour. Go ahead, Endeavour.
I don't know if you could see it in the TVs, but the parabolic antenna has a sort of a rippling to it, almost as if it were in a wind.
And we copy it, and we can see that. Endeavour Houston, request you zoom in on the lens so we can see if any of these perturbations are more readily apparent.
Okay, Bill, we'll put that to work.
Endeavour Houston, just for information, the CG of the combined system is 9 feet above the bottom of the Spartan.
Okay, Bill, that sure helps. We were trying to actually figure that out up here because it's obviously rotating a point about that point, and we were trying to keep that steady in the coast. Okay, we see the jettison, Houston, and the antenna was pointed away from us and slightly aft of the Spartan in the velocity vector.
Endeavour Houston for the flight deck.
Go ahead, Chris.
So we'd like a Ohm's interconnect tank switch. It's orbit pocket page 8-4, and it'll be from left to right.
Okay, Chris, we'll put that to work, switching from left to right.
And Kurt, when that's complete, we'd like a repress using helium press A.
AP-10, side B, early, hold. It worked.
Copy.
Endeavour Houston for Spartan.
Go ahead.
Yeah, at this point, what we'd like to do real quickly is see if we can get a view of the top of the Spartan and then go ahead and proceed with the berth and RMS power down.
Okay, and that's exactly where we were going, Bill. Rotating it now.
Thanks, John.
You got a good downlink?
Affirmative. Kurt, we'd like to stay in the RMS DAP, of course, until Spartan is berthed. You do have a go to maneuver, and of course, we need to be in free drift during the final berthing.
Bill, roger that. I followed the flight plan. I just want to make sure that the attitude in the flight plan was still good.
Endeavour Houston, we are with you in the Spacehab.
Good morning, Chris.
Good morning.
I'd enjoy an evening's work there. And we hope he doesn't break it. At least he can't drop it.
Looks good, Mark, and good morning to Kurt down there as well.
Hey, Chris, they don't let me back here very much. There's not much pilot science in the Spacehab.
Nice place to visit, Roger.
I've completed all the ARC steps. I wanted to give you some numbers if you're ready to copy on page 5-9. Completion of the ARC.
Sample 4 is in problem A. Houston Endeavour, door is opening if you can see it.
Roger, we're watching. Houston Endeavour, the STU satellite is on its way.
We copy, sounds great.
And Houston Endeavour, it looks like it has a bit of a tip-off right after it left the field of view. I'll pan the camera up so you can see it.
We copy, bit of a tip-off rate.
Endeavour, or did. Endeavour for
VTR-80,
do you have a picture?
Sure do, Mario. Good downlink.
Okay. Here. 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 Here.
does it so much at night.
Curl up in here.
He does it so many times at night, he's really good at night.
Real curl yourself in. And,
well on your way.
Okay, and that's it. 99.
Against that rough beard and go for it.
See, life is not totally abnormal in space.
To do it now is to inject it with air.
Ah, okay. Look at that.
The Garneau trick. That's a little easier than the.
Oh, that's neat. Oh, and look, it tends to go.
See,
to the center.
Reinverts.
Yeah.
It's like a shell.
Look at the surface tension, attaches kind of to the needle. Oh, you can see your reflection in it.
See? Yeah.
Or I mean your...
Beauty, what
okay.
A flyby. What a flyby, here you go.
Or see standby.
Maybe you can,
I can't hear you.
Okay, good. Okay, you can just let me drift down for a while.
Going down.
We need Andy up here to get a complete meal with everybody.
Now, ground them,
they
don't want us to let
them
do that.
Ooh, that's good. Sausage patty, yes. Andy, I can make an egg McMuffin.
closing. Very sad moment after 10 days. We have to close up the airlock for Spacehab with some regret as Andy puts the final closing touches.
All right, now we have an ops check here. We have your O2 hooked up. You can check your G-suit if you would, just a little bit, and make sure it's going to work.
Yep.
Okay, and we're going to...
Curtis, is it okay if I take your HUD cover off?
Yes, sir.
Your business.
Done.
And I'm auto-maneuver me that way?
Auto-maneuver?
Okay, okay, here we go. All right, well, that's not for you.
As a go for the deorbit burn.
Happy flight. Endeavour, Houston.
Go ahead.
The weather trends at KSC are very favorable. If you'd like, I can read you the new forecast, but basically weather has removed the occasional 1,500-foot broken 4 miles in fog, and the prevailing forecast remains the same. Based on that, you have a go for the deorbit burn.
Roger, we're glad to hear that. Go for the burn.
Cut off flight.
Copy.
Flight guidance, we see a good burn, good residuals.
Copy.
Flight prop, our left fuel aft gauge was a little bit biased, so we did get the left quantity message, no action, of course.
Copy.
Mile ago for command.
Copy.
Endeavour Houston, we have you through Mila, comcheck.
Loud and clear, honey.
Got you loud and clear, and we have an update on your weather at KSC. It's looking good. 13,000 scattered, 23,000 thin broken. Winds 250, 6 peak to 10. We saw a beautiful sunrise down here, and the STA says you should have no clouds on the hack.
Sounds good.
Endeavour Houston, we show you on energy approaching the hack. No change to weather. Your new winds are 260 at 6 peak to 9, and you are go for nominal drag chute deploy.
Roger, nominal drag chute deploy.
Flight CSS, all commanders flying.
Copy.
On at the 180.
Copy.
Endeavour, on at the 180.
Roger. This end, field in sight.
Copy, field in sight.
Gear down and locked.
Copy.
Main gear touchdown.
Copy.
Well, stop, Houston.
Max flight, any immediate deltas?
No deltas flight.
Okay, no
Welcome
deltas.
Welcome back, Endeavour, and congratulations on a highly successful flight. Endeavour, you set a record for the most rendezvous in the shuttle era, and the longest amount of time spent in rendezvous ops. Congratulations.
Roger, and thank you very much, Arlene, for all the support from your end.
When you look overhead, you see the flash.
Mark,
I know the flashes
you.
Have got lots of
look
flashes.
Behind you, Mark.
I know, it's been incredible. Incredible. I got lots of it.
Oh. All right. That's amazing.
It's spectacular. All right. Coming back to Earth.
Hey, got a little bit of drag on the vehicle. Two bar, 2 points. It was really bright out front.
After each flight, we like to get a quick photo of all crew members in front of the vehicle that was their home for the past 10 days.